So I'm out here with my helmet and I just put on a couple coats of primer. Kind of hard to see, but I'm gonna go around the helmet, show you all the damaged spots. So remember, this is a helmet that Rick picked up, not me, and I believe it to be a Fett Pride recast. You know, if I had bought it from the original, from the beginning, I would not have bought a recast, but you know, it wasn't my doing. This is what Rick picked up. So, you know, I know recasts are looked down upon. I myself look down upon them, but it's Rick's helmet, and the idea here is to keep Rick's helmet trooping in the garrison. So I'm redoing it, and hopefully it's gonna look good. Hopefully I've got all this damage in the right spot. I still have to put in the slots in the back. Oh, I probably should have done that first. It's actually primed anyway, so. Been playing with these templates, and it looks like I need to go 95%. It's a little smaller. And a little bit of cutting and pasting and Frankensteining. You can see there's a gap there, just to push things so that they go out to the edge where they're supposed to. Moving things a little bit there so it matches my damage. But it's basically 95% stencil. You can see where there's gaps. There's really nothing there, so it doesn't matter. There's nothing at the top there. But that's basically kind of what it's gonna look like. It's weird to kind of foreshadow it, right? To see what it's gonna be. Except for that giant white. That's not a mark. I should color it with a marker. But I think it's gonna work. This is gonna be the hardest part because of all the shading. All the other parts are gonna be pretty much just, it's only paint where there's damage. So
video. I just wanted to give a shout out to Minutefett on the dented helmet, who turned me on to this stuff. It is a fine tip applicator. This was an empty bottle. And I thought that the stuff was gonna come in it. So this was just the applicator. It's a reusable bottle. But this thing is a 20 gauge 0.5 millimeter. It is tiny. And I just put the masking fluid that I have, the Mask-All, into here. And earlier today, I had gone in and just done a little bit on the bottom. This was done with a paintbrush, so that's, you know, thicker lines, that's okay. But what I did was I also noticed that there was a little bit in the back here, so I used that fine tip, and I just wanted to show you the tiny little lines and little dots that I'm getting with this fine tip applicator. Of all of the paint I've done so far, I've never been able to get lines so small. And this applicator is amazing. So thank you to Minutefett. I think it's really gonna up my build here on the helmet. I wish I had this from the beginning because it's freaking awesome. So I'm gonna tape this up and I'm gonna paint the silver right now.
I am outside. I have just laid the first color, which is silver. You can see I've got a little bit of masking, just like JV did, to show the gray underneath, which is like, you know, an original gray color. I did a little bit, oh, I'm falling. A little bit in here, a little bit more over there. Pretty good job of no bleeding. I did touch it with my finger up here, but that's no big deal. It's so funny, you know, like this is the first visible color that we're gonna see, right? So like, I started giggling because it has begun. I mean, this, I'm scared to death, but I'm excited at the same time. So I'm pretty happy with this so far. I love the silver. I did about three coats. It went on very evenly. The thing is, like, I've got this masking here, right? And I want to pull it off. My favorite thing is to pull that masking off, but I can't. What'll happen now is I'll mask all the silver area, damaged areas, with the stencil, and then put the stuff on. And then we're gonna spray some grays. So a couple things, I'm using the Tamiya yellow tape, the really skinny one, and the one that's a little bit thicker. Also, I changed to frog tape instead of the blue 3M tape. It's a yellow, delicate surface basically, and it went on and off really quick. So I think it's a better tape. If anybody's looking for a good tape, try the frog tape. And when I did this, I did tape the entire helmet because you got to watch for spraying, you know, bleeding that goes in. It finds ways in, so you got to close everything up. It was suggested that you just do sections at a time, because even when you let the silver cure, if you leave, I feel like if you leave tape on it too long, it could pull up colors. Like in my jetpack, I had it pulling up silver. So I'm gonna only put tape, you know, like in sections that's not painted until I absolutely have to. And then the idea is, as soon as you paint, take that tape off as quick as you can so that you don't get any, you know, pulling up of paint. I was worried about not being able to see in there and see all that stuff, but you can see it awesome. Oh, it looks great. So here we go, boys and girls.